What's happening, family? So often we see many athletes struggling and just dealing with the pressures of being an everyday athlete. And one of the biggest challenges that they may or may not know who to talk to, where to go, everything like that. So in this episode of Beyond the Ball, we're going to give you some answers. We're going to give you some places and ideas to where you can begin to consider on how you can take that pressure off yourself and then be able to release it. Let's get into the episode.
Welcome to Beyond the Ball Podcast.
What's going on, family? It's Jonathan Jones, and this is Beyond the Ball. I want you to think for a second. Who is somebody that you know, right? Who is somebody that you know that they seem like they're never bothered by the pressures of life, right? They always seem unfazed. They show up, they're always on 10, they're always ready to rock, ready to roll. And then I want you to think, if they had to talk to somebody, would they even know who they needed to talk to? Y'all, and I want to share that with you today, because today's topic, I want to just dive into, right? I want to dive into and talking about taking care of your mental health. And the reason why I want to talk about taking care of your mental health is because, like, today, right? Today, not yesterday, not last week, not last month, not last year, today, I was feeling a little funk. I can't put my hand on it or my mind to it or even conceptualize in the words why I felt the way I felt earlier today. It was just a mood that just shifted, and it was like a dark cloud was just on me, right? Couldn't communicate. My wife asked me, "What's wrong? Like, what are you feeling right now? You look sad." And I was like, "I don't know, man. Like, I didn't know." So, after me and her talking, after we took some time and we prayed, then I went to the Quick Trip and I got a slushie. And I had a conversation with a gentleman. Then I started to feel like a little bit lighter, but yet still couldn't identify, couldn't pinpoint what it was or why I felt the way I felt. And I'm sharing this with you all because every so often I have those days and I have those moods, and I know if I'm having them, and I've graduated from college. I haven't competed in organized sports since 2011, right? And it's 2023 now. So I know that you're facing or you're dealing with some sort of stress and some sort of pressure one way or the other. Right. And today, what I want to talk about is giving you some solutions. So the first thing I want you to begin to consider, that if you ever find yourself in a funk, or you find yourself in a mood, or you feel different from how you typically would feel, I want to encourage you to do this. I want to encourage you to have, if you have a teammate, right, a close teammate, a close friend, a close fellow student, I would encourage you to talk to them. Right? Talk to them, share what you're facing, share what you feel. And this is somebody that you trust, right? You're not just gonna share this with anybody or everybody. This is somebody that you trust, and somebody that if you begin to open up to them, you know it's not gonna go from where you all were talking anywhere else. It's just gonna stay right there, okay? And this is somebody who we would like to think is like somewhat mature, right? Can handle the conversation. And you wanna make sure that you communicate to them, "I'm not asking you to give me solutions if you're not looking for a solution." You let them know, "I'm not asking you to try to fix it. I just want you to listen." And this is something I learned later in my life as I've gone to therapy for many years. I even went to grad school to be a therapist, right? But if you don't communicate to somebody what you want or what you need, then they're gonna assume that if you have a problem, you want somebody to solve it for you. They're gonna assume, or they're gonna project, because you feel sad, then they should help you solve that so they can feel a little bit better, right? But just communicate to them, no. I don't want you to solve it. I just want you to hear me out, and I want you to listen, right? So that would be the first piece I share with you, because more than likely, you're on campus, or you have a dorm, or you have an apartment, or you probably have roommates, more than likely, if you can get along with people, right? If you can't get along with people, then you don't have roommates. So therefore, if you go home by yourself in your dorm room at your apartment and you're facing this challenge by yourself as your individual, it can only grow, right? I once heard it said that a problem that was created, a problem cannot be solved in the same mind frame of which it was created. So let's consider that. The second thing I would just encourage you to do, maybe you're not the teammate who needs to talk to somebody. Like maybe you already have that taken care of, and maybe you already have somebody that you communicate with, and you've identified stressors and you know how to get rid of that. Then for you, I would suggest that you be the one to check on your strong friend, right? Check on your strong friend. John, what do you mean? The people that we see all the time that are on 10, they're always a leader, they're actively involved on campus. They're the one who are always in the public eye. But then let's say one day you typically have lunch together, and then they're not there to have lunch with you. Then let's say it goes on 2 days, and you're like, well, where are they at? You text them, they didn't text you back. You hit them up on Instagram, they left you on read. You're like, whoa, what's the deal? Like, what's happening? Where you at? Then I would encourage you to take drastic measures, right? And I'm not saying drastic, like do anything just super wild, but if you typically have met up at the cafe or at the Chick-fil-A or wherever it is you meet, but you know where they stay, like let them know, hey, I haven't heard from you in a couple of days. I'm gonna come to your apartment just to check on you. Shoot them a text, let them know. I'm gonna come and just check on you, just see where you at, see how you doing. Right? So at least they're aware of what's about to happen. Then you come and just like knock on their door and see if they answer. And the reason why I'm suggesting this, because I'm tired of seeing individuals who are suffering in silence and they're struggling and they're going through trying to figure out this life by themselves and they can't get solutions. So then some people end up taking their lives. They end up successfully committing suicide. They end up doing things out of their normal character because they didn't know somebody cared. They didn't think somebody actually would have missed them. We need to let people know, I'm here for you, right? I care about you. You mean something to me, right? So we want to check in. This is just another thing. Like, let people, if you have somebody who is a trusted friend, they come through always, they always support you, they always got your back, they're always encouraging. Let them know how much you appreciate them. Let them know, I appreciate you, I rock with you, all because you be holding me down all the time, right? We need to let people know that we care about them, that we love them. People who we care about and people who really mean a lot to us in our lives, we should communicate that. Because when we communicate that lets people know, I see you. You're relevant. You matter. Even despite accolades they may be received from sports and even from education or academia, we need to let people know, people to people, person to person. All right. That lets them know, like, I see you, I feel you, I know where you're at, I respect you as a person. I'm grateful for you as a person, right? I'm grateful for you. Those of you who can't see, you might be listening to the podcast. I just picked up my son and just put him on my lap and I gave him a little kiss, let him know I appreciate him. You know what I'm saying? I rock with this little fella. You know what I'm saying? You my guy. All right. And then the last thing I wanted to make sure that you all know is talking to somebody on campus. I did not take advantage of this when I was at my junior college. I did not take advantage of this when I was at my four-year university. But now there's a lot more resources and a lot more options that you all have on campus that I didn't have, or I just wasn't aware of because of my own ignorance, right? So I would just suggest to you, find out if you all have a psychology department, and then find out if you all can get counseling. If you can just talk to somebody, right? Because you might not want to talk to your coach. You might not want to talk to teammates. But if you're in the position to where you're like, I'm ready to talk to somebody and I need some answers, I need some help navigating through these emotions, navigating through what I feel, why I feel it, where is it coming from, and just unpacking things or even just having a check-in. Nothing has to be wrong for you to go see a therapist. I go to a therapist now, not as often, but when I was navigating through some things, I was in there every week. You hear me? Like, I'm talking about every week. And then I started crying in there and I apologized. I was like, I'm sorry. And he was like, why are you apologizing for what you feel? And I was like, dang, that's good. I'm not sorry, actually. Right? So talk to somebody. Talk to somebody, right? And I just want you to know that I care, okay? If you're listening, if you're watching, wherever you are, I've been a student athlete. I've been there. The pressures, the ups, the downs, the two-a-days, the ice baths, the film room, study hall. Like, I've been there. The workouts out in the sun, running on the soccer field. Then the pool workouts, the weight room, like all that. I've been there. I've done it. I know what you're facing. And trust me. Trust me when I tell you this. Not only am I the one that cares, but there are many other people who care for you as well. Please, please, if you're feeling something that you need help navigating through, talk with a teammate, talk with a coach, academic advisor, a therapist, whoever it needs to be, so that you can get what you're feeling out of your head and on your heart out, okay? So you can release that. And then the last thing I want to share with you all is this. But before I share this, first I want to say, if you have any questions for me, or, you know, if you'd like me to do a deeper episode on mental health, or you'd like me to do a deeper dive, just comment down below if you're watching on YouTube, or if you're listening on Apple, then just comment in the review. Like, write a review, but say, hey, John, do you mind attacking this topic? Or, hey, John, can you talk a little bit more about this or with that? But some of the resources I want to share for you is this. One, Abraham Scully is my guy. Abraham came on the podcast. He's on episode 77, and we talked about how to fight depression. I'm going to link that up in the show notes. And then I also interviewed him and his wife on our other show, right? Our other show, which is called Your Podcast Mentor. And I'm going to link that up as well, because those are two good episodes where he gives tangible, practical tips and guidance. So I'm gonna link that up. And he also wrote a book. I was gonna bring it in to record, but I left it in the other studio. So his book is called Unlearn the Lies. That's the title of his book, and that's also the title of his podcast. So I'm gonna link that up down in the show notes as well, so you all can hear that, dive in, take full advantage. But family, once again, this is Beyond the Ball, and this is presented by Beyond the Ball Media. My name is Jonathan Jones, and just know that if you feel that at any point that no one loves you, just know that God loves you and I love you, all right? It's Jonathan Jones, and this is Beyond the Ball, where we help you succeed beyond your degree.